control.
Holy shit.
Chloe, you're back.
Whoa, down, Max. You get one kiss, now you're all over me?
I'm so glad you're here.
You sound high, but thanks for the morning grope. Since we were up all night playing CSI Arcadia Bay, I was still spaced out here trying to put all this info together. Max, did you forget we've gone over this? I hope you weren't messing around with time while I was sleeping.
Not anymore. I'm just spaced out, too.
Welcome back to the real world, Max. I don't think I can ever tell Chloe about what happened.
Let's look at the big board and see all our pieces in the puzzle so far.
Getting lost in all this shit.
Damn. This is a serious exposé on the Prescotts. Finally. Even Holmes and Watson didn't use every piece of information. Staying up all night is the best excuse to drink lots of coffee. I wish I could tell Chloe how much William cared about her.
I feel like we're missing a major clue.
Keep digging, Chloe.
Yes, Chloe Price was here. There's Chloe's cash stash. Sorry, Principal Wells. I'm so sorry, William. It's not fair you had to die twice. This butterfly photo seems like a million years ago. How much time have I altered since? I still feel sketchy about giving Chloe the gun back. That snow doe always makes me think of William and Chloe. That's my Chloe.
So close, yet so far away. We have to do three main things.
Right. What things?
One, decipher Frank's logbook. Two, get Nathan's phone to find out where he's been during the Vortex Club parties with Kate and Rachel. And see whatever hidden shit he's got in his messages.
Three, beat Stepdouche Dan until he tells us about Frank, Nathan, and the darkroom. And I do have a gun now.
Keep it in your pants. We'll have to do this on our own.
Dude, at least let me kick his ass, then rewind. Fine, whatevs. It's your power.
Which I can't waste on shit like that. Or Blackwell would be in big trouble.
At least you let me take that money to pay Frank off.
Don't remind me. I just want him off your back. Our back.
I know. You should get busy in the garage to see what dirt you can dig up. I'm gonna cyberstalk some names and see where that leads. Or to who. And be careful of Stepcrack. He's not gonna be a happy camper after you reamed him yesterday and Mom is giving him the boot.
I'm on it, partner. I can't be. Oh no. That poor little bird has been trapped in here. That blue dye makes me so happy. It means the real Chloe is back with me. Last time I wanted to splash some water on my face, my whole life changed. Since David might be in there, I better mosey along for a change. Oh shit! Poor thing. It's such a warm, beautiful day. How could a killer storm just pop up tomorrow? Fly, be free.
You won this battle, Max. You broke up my family. I salute you.
David, I didn't try to hurt you. Ever. But I won't let anybody hurt Chloe.
Too late, isn't it? You just better be damn careful with her. Don't you wander off into the dark.
David isn't any different from me when he's looking at those family photos. Those poor whales are like beached angels. What is going on here? Ouch. My butterfly sketch doesn't exist in this timeline. Like William. Max the Time Bandit strikes again. William never finished painting that wall. Poor birds. I guess David wasn't in the mood to clean up. To think this all started with my vision of a tornado. Joyce must be so upset. Are you helping anybody, Max? It looks like David finished his car repairs. Maybe there's some new clues around. Baby blue jay eggs in the nest. I better move his plank if I want to take the shot. This plank is good for nest protection, but bad for a nest photo. Excuse me. Just one picture, please. Oh, please don't make these little birds die like the others. Another photo from my Arcadia Bay wildlife series. Oh, thank you. Sleep tight, my eggy wags. Whoa, that is a serious padlock on that locker. Hey David, what you hiding? I knew that number would be important. Oh, maps, notes, coordinates, photos of Kate, Nathan. Oh, yes. Score. Back to Chloe now. Surveillance cameras at Pan Estates? David must be working for the Prescotts too. Should I have signed the petition? Blackwell sure isn't safe and private anymore. Oh meow, Miss Grant. Twist that knife. At least he has one weird fan. Wish I had surveillance footage of that conversation. There's more to David Madsen than meets the eye. He should finish this letter to Joyce. Oh, jeez. David is packing up wedding stuff too. Oh, that makes me sad. It was so incredible to see William again. I wish Chloe could too. Either Chloe stole another gun, or David is out there armed. What the hell did David do for Nathan? And what did his dad do for David? I wonder if David is going to the party. It's amazing how much drama this living room has seen.
Yo, Chloe! Are you ready yet? I have to get back to my dorm.
Are we happy?
Very happy. I hit the secret file jackpot. Kate, Nathan, and Rachel. Plus some location coordinates. David is like a one-man surveillance army. Now let's get the hell out of here before we get busted.
Now let's go find out what Nathan is hiding in his room.
We have to be extra careful.
Max, now it's time for Nathan Prescott to be afraid of us.
Hey, Max. How you doing?
Oh, hi, Mr. Jefferson. I'm okay. And this is my friend, Chloe.
Yeah.
Chloe? Why isn't somebody as cool as you going to Blackwell?
I was way too cool for this school. It's a long story. In actual files here.
I can imagine. Max, are you sure that you're all right?
It's weird just being on campus like everything's normal.
I know. Lame as it sounds, life has to go on.
I think there's too much going on in my life.
On that note, Blackwell duty calls. Remember, I'm going to announce the winner of the Everyday Heroes contest tonight at the party, so I hope you'll be there to celebrate, even though I'm sorry you didn't enter a photo. I understand your reasons. You can't force an artist to work.
I feel like a total loser, but it's been a hard week to focus. No pun intended.
I'm proud of you for caring so much about a troubled friend. And I take hope in the fact that you have plenty of time to find your way. Just get in the habit of putting your work out there.
Thanks, Mr. Jefferson. I'll definitely be there tonight.
Me too. I'll be Max's date. You better dance with us at least once.
Nobody should have to see me dance. Plus, you don't want to watch the old hipster trying to keep up with the kids. I have some pride. Be seeing you.
Yes, you will. Hot for teacher.
Gross! You're out of control.
Not yet. Just wait until the rager tonight.
Shut up.
Don't be jealous because Mark Jefferson thinks I'm cool.
I am so ignoring you.
Fine. Since I'm here, I'll see if I can get some dirt from Justin. I haven't talked to him in a while.
Now that is a great plan. Let's see if I can find out where Nathan is. Principal Wells was so loaded the other night here. Poor Daniel. Looks like he needs a hug. Hey, Daniel. You look bummed out. Are you alright?
Hola, Max. I just figured out that my photos basically suck. I'm a wannabe artist.
You're not here to be a photographer. That's my gig. Look at that sketch you did of me. Incredible. And that's your art. Your gift.
I do feel better now. You are good, Max.
Have you talked to anybody about what happened with Kate?
I don't talk to anybody, Max. But, I did actually have a conversation with Brooke. She was very sad about Kate.
So am I. And angry.
We should stop going to class and stage a protest. But that's not going to happen at Blackwell. Yet.
I like this revolutionary Daniel Da Costa.
Only if I can start the revolution from my sketchbook, Max.
By the way, have you seen Nathan Prescott?
Oh, I heard a rumor he's actually suspended.
Yeah, but he's still gotta be on campus.
That explains why he looked so pissed off when I saw him leaving campus a few moments ago.
Are you going to the end of the world party tonight?
It will be if I go, man. People here push me into lockers, not dance floors.
That's exactly why you should go to that party. We have to stand up to these Blackwell bullies for Kate. You won't be alone, Daniel.
Not with you to back me up, Max. Oh, damn it. I will go to the party like it is the end of the world. Okay, maybe I won't go, but... No, I won't do that, but I'll go.
Let's talk later. Okay, Daniel? Good. Nathan is not around. I should go back to Chloe. Hey, Daniel.
Hola.
You're not
here.
Have you?
I don't.
So am I.
We should stop.
I like this.
Only if I can.
By the way.
Oh.
Yeah, but.
That explains why.
Are you going?
It will.
Screw the Vortex Club. They don't deserve you, Daniel.
They don't deserve anything. I mean, what do they actually do for Blackwell, huh? You're right, Max. Screw them.
Let's talk later. Okay, Daniel? Hey, Daniel.
Hola.
You're not... Have you...
I...
So am I.
We...
I like this re...
Only if I...
By the way.
Oh.
Yeah.
That explains why...
Are you going to the end of the world?
It will be if I go, man. People here push me into lockers, not dance floors.
That's exactly why you should go to that party. We have to stand up to these Blackwell bullies for Kate. You won't be alone, Daniel.
Not with you to back me up, Max. Oh, damn it. I will go to the party like it is the end of the world. Okay, maybe I won't go, but...
Let's talk later. Okay, Daniel? Enjoy the big game, Zachary. I hope it's not the last.
I had to clear away another batch of dead birds today. Sad,
Makes me That's mad. Cool to see that Samuel's not alone for once.
How are you doing, Max? Been a tough week. I know.
Yes, it has, Samuel. How are you?
Sad and confused, like everybody else in Arcadia Bay. You look like you have a lot of questions, too.
More questions than answers.
Samuel is always here to talk.
Blackwell is so sad and quiet since Kate isn't here anymore.
Yes. You can tell that the campus is different now. And you reached out to her when everybody turned away.
Samuel, you're the eyes of Blackwell. Did you know Kate was being bullied?
Most everyone makes fun of me. But Samuel warned them about Kate. I hate bullies, Max.
I believe you.
Kate just needed some more helpful spirits like her friend Max. I hope she finds them now.
Have you seen Nathan Prescott around?
That would be hard since he was suspended.
He deserved it. And more.
Samuel tries not to judge people. But Nathan shouldn't be here. Maybe he's supposed to be here, though.
What do you really know about him?
Not enough to help you, Max. I truly wish I could. I see what you're doing.
Do you ever talk with David Madsen?
He talks to me. I listen.
That's how David operates.
He sees things, not people. But I think he sees you, Max.
Why do you say that?
Because you both see with cameras.
I think you have better vision than both of us.
No, Max. I just look at everything from a different angle.
I definitely have questions about what's happening to the animals in Arcadia Bay.
Oh, many do. These poor creatures have no choice in what happens to them.
How can anybody explain all those poor beached whales?
My dad was a fisherman, and he'd take me out to hear the whales sing. Now they just cry.
Do you think this is some kind of eco-disaster, or...?
I think it's more than that. Somebody is causing all this to happen.
You think so, Samuel?
You and Arcadia Bay are connected by time and tide. So, next time I have a question, I'm coming to you.
Well, I'm glad to see your squirrels are still healthy and happy on the campus.
Me too. If something happened to them... Oh...
Not as long as you're here to take care of them, Samuel.
The only thing that calms them is food. Lots of food. Which reminds me that I have to feed them now. I think everything is changing here.
As a scientist, I'm fascinated. As Michelle Grant, I'm very worried.
Okay.
Sorry to bother you again, Samuel.
There's no bother here, Max.
I definitely have questions about...
Oh.
What do you think about all those dying birds?
Samuel had to bury dozens near the Tabanga.
Is that cool with the Tabanga?
We'll find out if the souls of the bird move on. Not that we can prove it.
It's so ominous.
Unless it's fate, then it doesn't matter.
I still have a million questions about what's happening to Arcadia Bay.
That must be why Miss Gant says you're one of her favorite students at Blackwell.
Even though Miss Grant likes me, I have zero science skills to explain that eclipse.
As I was just saying to her, that's because science has no explanation. No offense to Miss Grant here, but this is just the beginning.
Beginning of what?
Oh, I don't believe anything ever ends. Especially time. That's why I can sense something bigger is coming to Arcadia Bay. And Max, I don't like it at all.
I keep thinking that Rachel Amber has a few answers. If we can find her.
If Rachel wants to be found.
Do you think she's alive?
She'll always be alive in our hearts. Sometimes, that's all we have left.
But...
Max, all I can tell you is to stay on your path and you'll find what you're looking for. Rachel Amber is waiting too.
I'd rather be in her class than the Vortex Club.
Yes, you would. Rachel saw right through them.
She's not the only one.
Nobody should be trapped in the Vortex Club. Get out now, Max, while time is on your side.
I'm sorry. I better get going now.
Your bay is scared, too. Look at the weather.
Mrs. Grant looks interested in whatever Samuel's saying. Hi, Miss Grant.
Max, you always show up when I'm talking about you. I'm still bragging about you and the other students making Blackwell surveillance free.
I was hoping you could explain some of these crazy things happening in Arcadia Bay.
If I could, I'd be collecting my Nobel Prize in Science today. I haven't been able to wrap my mind around that eclipse, much less the snow in Wales.
I think this is beyond science.
Nothing is beyond science except for our lack of knowledge. We may never know why, but that doesn't change reality.
I am worried about reality. I feel like it's changing right in front of us.
You and Samuel both. We were talking about that before you came over. Our planet is changing, but it's not mystic. It's erosion.
So, you don't think this could be some kind of prophecy or something?
Max, you know how fascinated I am by Arcadia Bay legends. But I haven't found any apocalyptic signs yet. Unless you count those end-of-the-world posters. Unless you know something I don't.
What about wormholes and chaos theory? Like time travel stuff.
The only wormholes in Arcadia Bay are underground. And chaos theory is just that. But if this is about time travel, sign me up.
Would you really change time?
Not after reading that Bradbury story, A Sound of Thunder. I won't give it away, but it involves dinosaurs and butterflies. Time is like a thread, Max. One tug and it all can unravel.
I was looking for Nathan Prescott, and I thought he might be in your class.
Mr. Prescott has no class at all after his suspension. I didn't think you were friends.
You probably know him better.
I've tried. Nathan is a Prescott, and with that comes a lot of baggage. Too much for one teenager. This week was the proof. Principal Wells did the right thing.
I know. Nathan needs real help.
Yes, he does, Max. I did try once, but Mr. Prescott didn't appreciate my help. I did see Nathan leaving the campus looking angrier than usual, so... maybe it's good you haven't found him.
I don't think surveillance would have helped Kate Marsh.
Oh, Max. I'm so sorry you had to go through that. Kate was the sweetest student I've ever met at Blackwell. And they can be so cruel to each other. Do you need to talk to a counselor?
Blackwell Academy needs the help. There's something terrible going on here. You see it, right?
This week hasn't been Blackwell's finest hour. But me and some faculty members won't rest until all the students here feel safe, not bullied.
Kate was drugged at the Vortex Club party and bullied by them until she ended up on the roof. How do you stop that?
Shut down that damn Vortex Club for a start. I don't mean to get riled up, but that party should have been postponed.
It's extremely tasteless given what happened with Kate.
Do the Prescotts have anything to do with the Vortex Club? I mean, they don't get all their money from car washes.
No, they don't. But membership has its privileges. Especially when your father is Blackwell's biggest sponsor. This elitist nonsense has no place here.
You're right. I just wish this could be the school that I dreamed about before I came here.
I hear you, Max. I love seeing you and Warren and all my students at your best here. But you're all too young to be so cynical. But you truly give me hope.
I'm sorry, Miss Grant. I have to get going. I'll see you later.
It's always good talking to you, Max.
We all need to look out for each other these days.
Get that food in your belly. How would you like a partner for a quick photo op? Two cute little squirrels posing for me? If you insist.
I hope Max isn't pissed that Warren asked me to the drive-in.
Enjoy the big game, Zachary. I hope it's not the last. I'm glad Samuel let me know about these rocks. Rest in peace, birdies. One photo. For posterity.
Max isn't pissed that Warren asked me to the drive-in.
Brooke looks happy that she's going ape with Warren.
Hey, Brooke. How are you?
Considering what happened to Kate, I could be better. Are you okay?
I might feel better taking your drone for a quick flight.
Miss Grant caved and let me fly her again. So take a spin. I have to see what time I'm going to the drive-in with Warren on Saturday.
Oh, he asked you to go to the drive-in with him? Well, that's cool.
I love the drive-in in Newburgh. So old school, but so much fun. Like Warren.
Thanks. Back again, Brooke.
Are you sure you're all right?
I need to find Nathan. Have you seen him around?
I was distracted by Warren asking me out to the drive-in.
Nathan was suspended, but he should still be on campus.
I did see him this morning heading off campus. He looked more angry than usual. I wouldn't look for him now if I were you.
I can't get my limited brain around that eclipse and the beached whales. I was hoping the science department had some ideas.
Warren and I are supposed to compare notes and theories this weekend.
That makes sense. Two big brains are better than one. Or mine.
We'd get the Nobel Prize if we could explain this phenomenon, but even Miss Grant has no clue.
I have to go. Talk later, Brooke. Sweet Kate. Oh, great. Chloe stole money from the Handicapped Access Fund. We're going to hell.
Justin, it's been so long since I've seen you.
Because you're way too cool for us now, Chloe.
Way too much shit going on, man.
Try going to
I can tell that Justin is really into Chloe.
So I hear.
Any word
Chloe
at all?
Chloe fits in so easy with Justin.
Wish. I'm working on it.
And I miss her laugh when I fell off my board.
She was probably high.
Yeah, she had the sick nugs.
True dat. Okay, I have to bounce.
Come hang with us at the park sometime.
Coast is clear. It would be so cool if you and me were going to school here together.
But now you can have Mr. Jefferson all to yourself.
Ugh, you suck. Now let's get into Blackwell Ninja mode.
So lame they don't have co-ed dorms here.
Yes, because I want Nathan Prescott in the room next door.
Good point.
Wait here. Give me the signal if Nathan or anybody shows up.
I won't let you down, Batmax.
Now I just have to find Nathan's room. Who needs a dorm map anyway? At least I can see that Nathan isn't in room 106 or 108. They have one more meeting left. Who would steal cat pics? There's Eagle Eye Chloe scoping out the area for Nathan. Evan. Of course. That's why no shits were given. Evan rolls.
Max, what are you doing? Hurry up!
Apparently Logan missed this poster.
That's why you're so hot. Because you care.
Ugh, why hello, Trevor. And Dana. Are toilet paper wars mandatory in the dorms? Every photographer should have one blurry Bigfoot shot. Even after Kate, nobody here learned anything about bullying. Jerks. At least nobody messed with the Kate portrait. Zach or Logan? Who knows? Bro's got a bro. Ugh, skunkweed and video games. I sense Hayden is near. This can only be Nathan's room. This just makes me think of Kate. Hello, Warren's room. Hawking and him make a good team. Poor Warren. This is the work of Nathan. He's so lucky I'm a pacifist. Looks like one of the jocks did care about Kate. Oh, you Bigfoots. This can only be Nathan's room. Now I need to find Nathan's phone, or anything with clues. That's so cute and ironic. I can't believe Nathan still has it around. I thought Victoria had the photo bling, but once again, the Prescott's rule. That monochrome camera is brand new and cost about $6,000. Bastard. I don't think this prescription has helped Nathan. I'd cry too if I had him for a father and had to wear that suit. Let's see what Nathan hides in here. Holy shit! That's the gun Nathan used on Chloe. A gift from... Nathan likes his tortured subjects way too much. These films all have a dark pattern. Nathan took this from Kate's altar. Why? What is with this dude? Damn, Nathan. That's a nice shot. If only all your energy went into photography. It's so damn creepy, but the guy has his own style. I don't think one book can guide the Prescotts. That looks like a totally fun show. Even Nathan has a light side. That is so Chloe. Oh my God. Chloe. Oh, Chloe. I really hope they were all consenting models. Whale songs? Maybe this is the only soothing thing Nathan ever hears. That must be the lamp Chloe broke when Nathan drugged her. Yes, I would be cool with having this high-tech projector. These films all have a dark pattern. Nathan is way into this party. Bad sign. Oh, bastard. bastard. Now I remember why I hate you. And why Kate will get justice. Oh, man. Sean Prescott might be Nathan's real problem. Too bad Nathan isn't more like his sister. She sounds awesome. And far away. Yes, Nathan sure needs diet pills. This is strong stuff. What the hell are all those marks on the floor? Let's find out what you're hiding. Oh yes, little phone. You are mine now. Now I have Nathan's phone, so I can show it to Chloe. Well, before Nathan comes back. Damn, Nathan. That's a nice shot. If only all your energy went into photography.